just reading right along there on page 253, they introduce this text, this chapter. Each path is only one of a million paths. Therefore, you must always keep in mind that a path is only a path. If you feel that you must not follow it, you must not follow it under any circumstances. Any path is only a path. There's no affront to yourself or others in dropping it if that is what your heart tells you to do. But your decision to keep on a path or to leave it must be free of fear or ambition. I'll come back to that. I warn you, look at every path closely and deliberately. Try it as many times as you think necessary. Then ask yourself and yourself alone one question, and one question alone, and that is, does this path that I'm on have a heart? All paths are the same. They lead to nowhere. There are paths going through the brush or into the brush. Does this path have a heart is the only question. If it does, then the path is good. If it doesn't, it is of no use. Both paths lead to nowhere. But one has a heart and the other does not. One makes for a joyful journey. As long as you follow it, you will be one with it. The other will make you curse your life. One makes you strong, the other weakens you. So there's a couple of things that are implied there. First, going back to your heart, or your decision to stay on this path must be free of fear or ambition. In other words, the reason why you choose the journey or the path that you're choosing in your life shouldn't be out of fear or ambition. In other words, ambition meaning to achieve or attain a certain destination. Ambition is a good concept to apply in short term, to be ambitious overall. But if your ambition of being on a path is just to achieve something or attain something, remember we talked about getting something's not gonna cause us to feel better, change our lives, the attainment of it. In other words, the second implication here with this little snippet is that life's not about the destination of wherever you're going or the outcome or wherever you're headed. Life is about the journey and going from here to there. And what they're saying is you should ask yourself one question when it comes to what journey or path you choose in your life. And the one question you should ask yourself is my heart invested in what I'm choosing to do right now? So take your major, for instance. Did you choose your major out of pressure from your peers? Did you choose your major because your mom and dad did the same thing? Or did you choose your major because you actually have a passion and your heart is interested in it and you have a desire to do it for yourself and you enjoy it, even though it's hard at times? And that's just one metaphor, your major. Everything you do, all your decisions are going to amount to your path and your journey. Your journey consists of the decisions that you make each and every day. And what they're saying is, on your journey to go wherever you want to go, because no matter where you get to, your own personal destination, we all end up in the same place. We all pass at some point in time. So death is the only final destination that we all have in common, and that's the only place that we'll get to. It's really, how are you going to live your life in the meantime? What's the path that you're going to choose on your journey of life? Life is not about where you end up. Life is about the journey or the destination. And you don't want to be 85, 92, looking back and saying, man, I wish I would have done something that I enjoyed more for the past 80 years or so. I wish I would have done something that really was more meaningful to me and not just try to achieve or attain or get to some destination, because now I've gotten there and wasted the journey. So the journey that you're going to choose and in every decision that you make should be free of fear, meaning you shouldn't choose it out of fear. You shouldn't choose it out of the idea that you're going to achieve or accomplish something and that'll be all there is to it. The decision to follow a path, if you will, needs to have your heart involved. Now, you need to incorporate your brain as well. You need to be intelligent as well. But you don't want to be all brains, all strategy, no passion, no heart. All right? You've got to incorporate your brain. Your love has to be involved in the decisions that you're making. So that's a good introductory snippet there that says you need to consider whether or not you're invested in you, meaning your heart. Are you invested in the path that you're on, your journey, your vision, your outcome, your major? Are you invested? Is your heart invested? If it's not, that path isn't for you. Find another destination, another journey that has your heart involved in it. There's a million different ways to the same place. You've got to find out, am I living a life on a journey that I'm invested in? That's the introduction there. It just really shows you this concept, this idea. As you can see, we're not talking about something that's more of an art than a science. So here we're talking about how does it relate to you specifically? Meaningful is unique to each person. You've got to decide what's meaningful to you, and then you've got to make the decision for yourself and yourself alone. But what should determine those decisions are whether or not your heart's invested in those decisions and in that path.